Cunnamulla. Population 1,217. A town most Australians have either never heard of or rarely spare a thought for. Over 800 kilometres from Brisbane, 1,000 kilometres from Sydney, and 9,000 kilometres from India. This is the story of Sunny, a Frontier Services Patrol Minister who travelled 9,000 kilometres from his home in India to live his dream in the outback, where he delivers help and hope for the locals around Cunnamulla.
The last 5 years, the drought is very bad. People are going through a lot of mental health issues and financial crisis.
It's been tough. Everyone's finding it tough. The town's finding it tough.
From our point of view, yeah, we do tend to forget about what these guys have to put up with, and it's a real wake-up call when you do come out.
Your natural thing is to say, no, we'll be right. But then my son said, don't be a fool. Just get them out and have a yarn, and basically that's it. They're good company, yeah.
This is a story of mateship, the story of Sunny helping to bring people together a long way from home.
When I met Sunny, didn't really know what to think. He was a genuine bloke, happy, shook my hand.
From what I've seen of him, you can't get a better person.
He's making the most of it and helping a lot of people from what I've seen.
1 week in autumn, approaching its sixth year of drought, the longest on record, Cunnamulla welcomes a few visitors to town.
We live a pretty special life in the cities. Here's a chance to just help people that need help.
We're out there doing the general sort of work, a bit of painting, a bit of general maintenance. RACQ guys are out there doing a lot of the mechanical work.
If you were paying for that, that'd cost you thousands of dollars, and we're saving them that amount of dollars.
Coping with the financial side of things can be an emotional stress on you as well. To me, it's been a huge relief.
New faces, here to offer a hand where the help is needed the most.
I really understand what people are really going through because I also come from a poor family. We also have a farm. So I always ask them, even if they say no, when we are ready to reach out, they are very happy to accept the help from us.
When Sonny asked me, I said, these people are worse than me. I said, I wasn't expecting it, but he still went ahead and did it, and I very much appreciate it.
In the end, new friendships with stories for life amongst new mates.
Talking to the guys, they say that this sort of thing is the best drought relief help they've had.
They understand, they can see. It's beneficial to us, but it's great that somebody from, you know, the city dwellers that are actually acknowledging how graziers are struggling within dry times, you know. The mateship, the camaraderie, you know, we've had good, great yarns, great jokes. It's been great.
A helping hand is invaluable, but turning up and simply showing your care when someone needs it the most, that's what mateship's all about.
Feels like old friends sometimes, the way they welcome you into their houses.
As much as it's about the work, it's about the connection.
I am trying my best to be part of their sorrows as well as the happiness. Now everyone says Sunny is a member of our family.